So our first topic is FOMO. But before we go into the topic as such, we do a small prayer and we do a small ice breaking activity. Then we start. Om Sahana Bhavatu, Sahanam Runaktu, Sahaviryam Karavavahai, Tejasvinavadhitamastu Ma Vidvishavahai. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Have you heard this prayer before? You have heard it. Okay, so this is a universal prayer. Sahana Bhavatu means may the Lord protect us. Sahana Bhunaktu, may the Lord nourish us. Sahaviryam Karavavai, may we both put efforts together. Teacher and the student puts efforts together and knowledge arises. Tejasvinavadhitamastu, whatever we learn, may it be bright and may we be able to apply that in our life. Ma vidvishavahi, may there be no misunderstandings between us. Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. Three times we say Shanti. Any idea why? We just say Om Shanti and be quiet. We say three times Om Shanti Shanti Shanti. So there are three sources of disturbances which can come in our life. One source of disturbance is the cosmic source. There could be like heat, cyclone, drought, any substance, thunder, storm, whatever, cold. So the mind gets disturbed with that. Then there are disturbances which can come to us from people around us or the beings around us. Maybe somebody is playing loud music, somebody is chatting away, or somebody is distracting us, anything. And third is from inside us. There can be disturbances that can come from within us. Our mind may not be focused. We may be remembering something else. So may we not have disturbance from any of these so that we can get the right knowledge. Do you have any fear you have missed out on anything in life? Just now the exercise that we did, never have I done this.
Fear of missing out or something, like a
really
important
thing. Mm-hmm. Rare people have that fear. Generally, what type of fears do you have in terms of this? What do you feel you would have missed out in life?
The fastest roller coaster because of violence.
Oh, because of one?
Inch of height.
But now you can go, no?
Yeah, but again going to that same
place. Any other? You would have wished that, oh, I want to do this. I missed it out. Generally, when do we use this word FOMO? Is, you know, when something is happening, and you are not able to go, and you know that some other people have gone and they are enjoying, maybe your friends, your relatives, your family. Now suppose you have an exam.
Who was that at a point? When it's a board exam.
Yeah, that time a lot of FOMO will come. But not fear of missing out the exam, fear of missing out many other things because of that exam. You miss out, let us say now you Uri movie had come. And you wanted to go and see the first show. And your friends and all have gone, but you can't go there because of whatever reason. Some relative has come or somebody. And what do you feel then?
Because your mom told you to buy stuff from the shop.
Yeah, she gave you some work to do. So then.
Yeah.
No. When
you go shopping with your mom, because your mom can spend 3 hours in one shop. Then she can spend 3 hours in another shop. And the same cycle goes on. Until 8.
I'm so clever mom with shopping.
So FOMO is that feeling, you know, when people have the anxiety because they miss out on anything social where their friends are doing something or their family doing something. And a lot of times it is also connected with our social media. Which social medias are you all on?
I'm not on
Instagram.
Instagram? WhatsApp. You may have the FOMO of not being on social media.
No.
You are happy?
Yes, I am happy. Yes. People in my school type so many weird stuff on the phone, on the chat.
Right. So this fear of missing out, does it do anything to us? In the sense, is it harmful? Should we attempt to overcome it, or it's okay? It doesn't matter. You don't feel the anxiety that you know others are doing and I am losing out on it, you know. So what will the, how will I strike a conversation now when they speak to me about it? I don't know anything about
sometimes.
It. Does it feel like it depends
on the situation.
Okay. That is true, it depends definitely on situation. Something which I really value, if that I am not able to get to do, then I may feel left out. So this FOMO is something which is an apprehension, you know, and many times it leads to also loneliness. Some people feel that, you know, I am getting excluded, people are ignoring me, they are not including me.
But people ignore you because of stupid stuff.
That is possible, that is true. They have their own reasons to ignore. Sometimes they may not be ignoring, I may feel ignored. That also is possible. But many people nowadays, what happens is because they feel FOMO, it's a social anxiety. So they want to be continuously connected, be updated. Everything that is happening, they should be in the know of the things, you know, in family life, in their friend circle, in the society. Whatever is the latest trend, I must belong to that. It's a natural thing anybody human may have, but today the anxieties associated with that are increased a lot. And so people are doing stuff not because they really want to do it, they are doing stuff because of the pressure. And you know, everybody is doing it, so I also want to do it. Whether you really like it, whether you should do it, that one is not even thinking.
Also like if people like, if your friends are in college and they start doing some illegal stuff, then it's become a trend of the college, even you want to.
Yeah,
like the recent one, the attack in Kashmir. Everyone is posting it on Instagram, and after that, after two stories, you see them going for gully boy, drinking something else.
So it's become more of an image thing that, you know, everybody is doing, so I also should do it. How much you genuinely one feels for it? Some things one does with feeling, many things one does with just social approval, you know, belonging. So if it is in this way making me scared or insecure, then that fear is not healthy for me. If I am doing something just because I am feeling I am going to be left out, I am going to be alone, then I am moving in a direction where I am losing touch with myself. I am trying to conform to what people are doing. And that fear of doing it like that makes me completely more and more isolated from myself. And so it makes the, you know, it perpetuates the fear of having made the wrong decision on how to spend time and how to spend my life also. So many times it happens that, you know, the friends are doing something out there, enjoying, partying. I am sitting and studying. I may feel that, oh God, what am I missing out? They are enjoying their life. I am stuck up with this. So one can feel like that, that I made a wrong decision. Maybe I should not have taken IIT entrance or engineering or any other thing, you know, which may be very tough. And others are, you see them, they are enjoying happily. So then there may be this fear that I made a wrong decision. And also it makes me dependent a lot on social media. Because that's one of the ways to stay connected, to know whatever people are doing, so that everybody can tell, you know, that, oh, he's a very up-to-date guy, he knows everything, you know, anything you want to know about the recent latest happenings, ask this person. So constantly I'm on social media, One is to yes, know whatever is happening, that's a general trait, which is good. But one is to be very anxious about it and not pay enough priority to what you really want to do. What are your goals? What are your priorities in life? Keeping that aside, only for the sake of being in, you know, limelight or being popular amongst people, if one does it, then what happens? The psychological dependency to being online could result in anxiety where one feels disconnected. That is very strange. Now, I want to be connected with everybody, so I am doing this, but I also get disconnected. From whom? From myself. I forget who am I. In trying to conform to so many people, it's a simple example, football. So many people talk about football. Let us say I am not very familiar with football. I love cricket more. I don't know so many things about so many, you know, Liverpool and Manchester United and this and that and Chelsea and all that. And then just to conform, I may try to put so much of my time into that. Slowly, slowly, I may not have enough time to even know what is happening in cricket properly. But I'm just trying to conform to whatever is generally happening as the trend. So, the need to connect all the time can actually make me disconnected also. Hence, it is important that we figure out, am I acting out of FOMO? Some of the examples are here. You can give me more examples of conversation FOMO means what? I must have something to talk about when I meet people, and for that I should know whatever is the latest happening, whatever that field the youngsters speak about. Or so many of my friends have met together in a party, I could not go, now I am sitting and imagining what are they talking about me. Conversation FOMO. I'm missing out what they are talking about me. I'm missing out what they are talking in general. Conversation FOMO. TV show or series FOMO? Which is the most popular TV series right now? Or a game of whatever, Netflix? Game of Thrones. So if you have not seen that at all, then you may have FOMO of that. Or the latest season, you don't know what has happened. And somebody else knows before you, then you have a FOMO, oh God, I'm missing it out. So even though you have something important to do, you leave that and you finish that series. Binge watch it whole night, finish it, because I must not be caught not knowing about it. Some just few examples, a wedding or a party. Mukesh Ambani's son is getting married now. His daughter got married a few months back. And suppose somebody in your friend circle got invited there and went, and you have a fear of missing out. Or any such event, party, wedding, celebration, festival, anything. A delicious restaurant or a movie in town which you have not been able to see. So there is a lot of, any more examples of FOMO that one goes through?
Missing a school or a
particular
day? Yeah.
Missing a school trip? School trip,
definitely. Missing a
sportsman. Sportsman.
Missing a sports day itself.
I didn't really like sports day. All I had to move was bar.
That's your choice, na. You can take part in any competition also.
There were no competition. Missing out your favorite sport instead, like missing out your favorite sport, like for a competition, you know, like
match.
Yeah, match. Yeah. That's all. A sports match.
Family get together.
Missing out on family get together. Like, he's not on social media at all. There can be one FOMO of just that.
I'm not going on WhatsApp.
That's good, you have made some choice. But there are lots of young people who are there by compulsion. because they are fearing missing out. If I'm not on WhatsApp, then how will I connect? If I'm not on Snapchat,
put them on WhatsApp in the first place.
Sorry?
It's their parents' fault.
It's parents' fault?
Yeah, because like when you get your phone, it's either for, because it's mostly for social media, like Facebook, whatever.
For
like that.
For communication.
It's for communication, but then you have to be the appropriate age to communicate. You can't be
able
to
say, I'm coming to Juhu, it takes me 1 hour to come here. I need a phone for, to call my mom and let her know that I'm in this class.
Yeah,
I don't necessarily have to be on Instagram the whole time.
It's kind of necessarily
improved. I have a phone and I'm not on social media.
Even not on social media.
That's what
you
it
can
is.
Have social media even if you don't have a phone.
So that fear of missing out is just that feeling. So they are not on social media. There's no fear of missing out. But if one wants to do social media because one wants to do, then that's a good thing. That's a different thing. But if I'm on social media because everybody else is on it and I'm missing it out, then that's insecurity. So what we need to do is identify that in my life, is there any such fear? Can you name any one fear which you go through of missing out? Any specific FOMO that you have?
Friends, yeah, right? Friends place overnight.
Friends place overnight, yeah.
That, like long drives and not going to some places.
Right. Count. Anyone else wants to share?
Going to a particular tuition which is a friend goes.
So you feel that you are missing it out because your friend goes there and you are not able to go there. Any other? But do you feel that that is something that we should overcome? Or it's okay, let it be there.
You should be prepared. You can go. You can go. If they go to a better part, you will go better. Simple as that.
What? The same thing you're saying. If they go to a better part, you also go.
Let go.
Or let it go.
Just let go. Go your.
Yeah, that means you are saying you overcome that fear.
Overcome
that FOMO. Right. You can't follow the
same person to the same party.
Same person with the same party. Right. But if you go, then you will go. So, what does FOMO do to me if I understand that? FOMO is connected to. Simple, you must have had this situation. You are trying to talk to somebody and the person is not interested, constantly is on WhatsApp, social media, doing something. Will you be able to strike any good genuine conversation? How does that make you feel if somebody whom you are talking to is on the phone, is not giving attention also? Do you feel like continuing? Or you feel like just moving away and best part is you move away, that person doesn't even recognize that you are gone. There is so much into that phone all the time. This is a simple situation, but it can also lead to a lot of dangerous situations. So, this is one question. Do I have FOMO or am I a MOFO? What is MOFO? No, not a dumb person. Just like FOMO has a full form, MOFO also has a full form. It's very easy, very simple if you try to guess it. Missing out is good, so half the battle done. FO is remaining. Not fear. Because you have FOMO, it leads to MOFO.
Missing out friends, fun.
Okay, missing out friends. It is possible, it can be missing out friends also. But what is over there?
Outing.
Okay, but that's what is FOMO. You are missing out, friends outing, you are missing out, that's FOMO. How does it make you MOFO? Because I have FOMO, many times when I am constantly wanting to be online, MOFO means missing out forever only. All the time one is out online. One is really missing out on real things happening in the life. Spending time with family, spending time with friends, you know, being with nature. Many things one misses out, being in the moment, because all the time I am online. So I am missing out forever online. And why am I doing this forever online? Because I have FOMO, I have fear of missing out something which is happening, which is the latest. People are addicted to phone and social media. They many times they spend hours together. Nowadays that's why they have that screen time. You know how much screen time you have spent on which apps. So they will tell you so that you understand, okay, this much I am doing. I'm spending this much time on a Facebook or on a WhatsApp or an Instagram or a, you know, just browsing a site, whatever it is. Because people are actually missing out on real life connections. Even in the same house, family members who are there, they are not talking to each other, but they are sitting in different rooms and WhatsApping. Mother is calling the child to eat food. By WhatsApp, beta, come down, eat food. Child also comes down and says, I am on the table. So it goes on. So when we have this fear of missing out, constantly hooked on, then we are online, we lose out on many new things in life. So what is the result of this FOMO? One wants to say yes to everything because of the fear of missing out. One forgets the priority. Everything one wants to say, yes, yes, I'll do this, I'll do this, I'll do this. And especially online, one keeps on accepting friends, keeps on replying to the messages, keeps on browsing, keeps on knowing so many things. So a person loses touch with what one really wants. It also serves as a motive for an increasing use of social media. Because I want to know more, I use more social media. And all the phone companies are very happy with you. Because they will consume more data, more money they get. So the increase in social media happens. And many times there is less attention to the class. So many people, while they are sitting in the class, they start texting. They are not paying attention. Whether in a school, now I don't know at which age they allow the phones in the...
They don't?
In what age they allow?
You can bring it with permission, but you're not allowed to use it in class.
Not class.
Some international schools have it, but
yeah.
Normally the ones with the ICSE boards don't have.
Even IGCSE don't have.
After which standard you can bring, but you can't use it.
Second, high school.
9, 11, 8, 9. So many times that happens that attention is not there in class, in work, you know, so much, even on the phone, on the computer, the notifications keep coming.
In work, if your boss catches you doing something, He'll cut your money and then he'll fire you.
He'll probably too busy Snapchatting himself.
Yeah.
He'll
cut your money.
They may not be bothered about that as long as you perform and you show the results which they want.
You don't perform, you don't do any work.
If you don't do, then of course you'll get fired, you'll get...
You won't get fired.
Performance appraisal
will
not
come. Before you get fired, sir, he's going to give you a rough cut off a lecture and then he'll be fired.
No one will be like that
actually. Maybe
no one will be like that for 8 hours continuing on board.
Yeah. People may not, people who are distracted to that extent, of course, they lose their job, but very few people will be like that. They'll keep doing in between, so their concentration keeps breaking. That's a very subtle thing to even identify. Not many bosses will even know that. The most dangerous part is driving. While driving, one is trying to answer a friend request or reply to something. That is ridiculous. But people are there who are doing it. So it leads to a lot of unhealthy digital habits. Constantly checking email, social media, and less interactions with actual people. You know, when earlier days we used to write letters. Nowadays there's nothing written. Everything is on social media.
It may have many disadvantages, but it has many advantages.
Yeah, like that everything has advantages and disadvantages. But there is a personal touch which comes when you write. Nowadays one is losing that. Very easily one just types happy birthday, sends it on WhatsApp, done. And send with all the emoticons of cake also and flower also and bouquet also and you know celebration, everything, so much and send over, shut up. What happened? I finished mission, done. People don't even take the effort to take the phone and call and talk. Forget writing it and you know making a greeting card or sending it. So the personal touch one starts losing. And more one becomes identified with the social media part. Nothing wrong in using social media, but never it should be done with this attitude of insecurity that you know I'm missing out something, so all the time I need to be online. So this FOMO is one such thing. It has a negative effect on people's overall mood and life situation. If I use it well, great. But if I don't use the technology and social media etc. properly, then it has a very negative effect. And lot of behavior is because of that, fear of missing out. Just now, what went? Valentine's Day went. So many people have fear of missing out. I don't have anybody.
Yeah, I'm single.
Good.
Excellent it is actually. If you don't have anybody.
Like?
If you have also great, if you don't have also great, but just because you don't have, desperately they will want somebody. No, today I want to do something. Why? You're saying something?
People in my school don't care. They will date anybody as long as they need to have a wedding.
That's what I'm saying. You get anybody. What? Who is the person? What happens? What is very common? To date anybody you like. That one.
In middle school, yeah.
But that's the fear of missing out. No, where I need to belong. And I have to ensure that there is somebody with me. Genuinely when you feel and there is a relationship you are in, that's a different matter. But desperation, just because I need to have somebody, people make such wrong choices because of that. So that is this, it has a negative effect and it can be very very dangerous. Just imagine getting stuck in a relationship, one can get emotionally hurt so badly. Because I didn't choose rightly. So whether it is driving, whether it is relationships, whether it is you know, peer pressure. When you go to college, a lot of people will tell you, you must have drugs. And just to belong to a group, one tries.
And
one feels that you know somebody says that you are young, you should try everything once. You know, there is nothing, you are going to miss out on this. When people say like that, I always to tell them what you know. Try potassium cyanide also once. Should try everything once and try potassium cyanide also. What is harmful to me, I should just say no. Why should I even indulge it? But this fear of missing out brings a lot of peer pressure. Relationships, drugs, alcohol, speeding, so many of these. I put myself in danger, I put other people in danger. So FOMO is one thing which I must identify, which are my fears like that, which are born out of my insecurity, and how should I overcome those. I'm going to share one video where it tells you about what are the stages of this FOMO. It's a very nice video. Just so that you understand that how this FOMO works.
What everyone, it's your boy Scudrow. What everyone, it's your girl Superwoman FOMO. The fear of missing out, aka all your friends are out, but you're stuck at home and you're 100% sure they're gonna see a double rainbow without you.
Yeah.
Listen, we all go through it. It happens to the best of us. In fact, that's the reason I almost failed English class. Yeah, I don't want to stay home and study. Also, you know what? No, that's untruly. Yeah, I also just think English are very difficult. Stages of FOMO, get ready to relate in a very real way, not when your mom just has like a brown guy over. It's like, this is also now, and you're like, since when? But like, relate in a very like real, like you could draw the family tree. You know the relationship. Get ready to relate. Stage one, discovery. When you first realize that you might be missing out on something epic, it feels like a dagger has gone through your heart. It's so painful. It's like, bang, lightning bolt, okay? Just like Harry Potter forehead's gone through your cardiovascular system. Why? It sucks. Oh my gosh, she's pregnant? What beach is this? Oh, yeah, that looks good. Oh, hello. What a cute puppy. Pool party? Did you're telling me that right now, in this moment, other people are doing things without me and still having fun? Which leads to stage two, panic. Now the song 0 to 100 real quick, real effing quick, was written for me in this stage because all chill has left the building. I basically do everything I possibly can to blow up the situation. I'm talking over-exaggerating, defense mechanisms, excuses, anger, justifications, all things. It's like every unhealthy thing I can do with the thoughts in my brain I am doing. It's like being possessed by irrational thoughts, and not even Dr. Phil can perform the exorcism. Swimming pools have so many germs. Ew. Gross. I'm so glad I wasn't invited.
Yeah.
Have fun swimming in people's pee. I hope they ain't asparagus. Why wouldn't they invite me? Oh my god, am I annoying? Is this something everyone else knows that I don't know? Am I the annoying one? Oh my god, I'm the annoying one. I have no friends. No one likes me. I should be more like SPF flirty. Yeah, how's that supposed to protect you from the sun? Joke's on you, idiots. So dumb. They're so dumb. I'm all over the place. Kids just like, oh, okay, you're having fun without me. That's okay. I don't mind, but also I have a lot of feelings and maybe we should do a blood pack and then never speak again. Which leads to stage three, avoidance. Yeah, after losing my goddamn mind, I hit a point where I'm like, you know what? I actually have this. Everything is fine. I'm actually, in fact, too good for the situation. This is actually exactly what I would have wanted. Of course, this is 100% not true and completely a defense mechanism, but I'm really good at pretending. Actually, no, this is actually good. I need to disconnect from technology. Yeah, spend a little alone time. Totally. I need to focus on me. How to focus on me. Stage four, desperation.
Why am I included? Why am I invited?
I need an invitation. I'm about to poke strangers on Facebook. I'm about to try to look for friendship on Tinder. I'm about to legally change my name to Phoebe just so I can say that once upon a time, I had friends. Your girl is getting desperate.
I don't even know why I'm tripping. I have so many amazing friends.
Like Kevin. Oh my god, yes, Kevin's amazing. Hey, Ken, my man, what are you doing?
Oh my god, really? Hi. Yeah, what am I doing? Nothing, you know, just slaying a dragon, claiming a castle.
Oh, okay, yeah, cool, yeah, do you want to handle anything?
You're already here, my princess.
Can we make some magic?
What? No, I promise.
Okay. No problem. Like, no, wait, you're not your mad face. I'm not about to hang up with my friend right now, Jack.
Daniels.
I'm just kidding, I'm talking to my friend Dom.
Julio.
JK, I'm talking to my friend. Absolute.
Vodka. Okay, this joke is done.
Stage five, passive aggressiveness. See, I'm irritated, but I'm also bottling it up, so now my emotions are just gonna seep out in the most petty way possible. The goal here is simple. Take you on a guilt trip, but also pretend not to care.
Like, yo, why should I invite Bravo? Whatever, yo, chill.
So cool, but where's Lily? Isn't she your friend too? She's pretty. LOL, hi, LOL. Your pool party looks so fun, LOL. Hope you're well, LOL. I just think it's funny how...
Which finally leads us to stage six, adulthood. After you're done being in high school and hitting puberty all over again, you decide, you know what, maybe I should handle this situation like a mature adult. So what do? You spend 45 minutes rehearsing dialogue so you can have a conversation head on.
Hey, yeah, I just wanted to say that I'm a little hurt that you didn't invite me to your pool party. I thought we were friends.
And that's when you find out the truth.
What are you talking about? I did invite you. You didn't respond.
Oh.
Come over. We're partying all night.
Sounds like fun. But I can't. I'm busy. Thanks anyways, though. Miss you.
And the truth is that you weren't gonna go regardless because you're antisocial, you're lazy, and there's probably traffic. And that's the tea. Also, wait, before we go to the end card, I mean, I had to do this. This video is called Stages of FOMO. Thank God we have great books like this one letting you know how to let go of FOMO. How to be boss, little thing. If you didn't know and you're new to my videos, I did write a book and like it was a bestseller and I think it's really good and it's called How to Be a Boss and you can get it in the description. If you want, now you can go to the end card.
So, what are the stages? Six stages.
Discovery,
panic,
avoidance,
so what do you learn from that video? Anything you want to share?
She didn't read the message.
That is true, she didn't read the message and she felt very insecure. And you just see how much the mind went through.
First you need to calm down and then
too hyper. Sorry. Too hyper, not sure. And just imagining so many things. My friends have left me out, I'm ignored, and they are having a good time, and you know. So am I not worthy of friendship? All those kind of thoughts went in my head. Discovery and then panic. At the end of it, what happened finally? She didn't even go. So much of mental energy wasted in that. So tell me one more thing. Is FOMO related to exam also?
Yeah.
How is FOMO related to exam?
Like if you miss your board, you need your results to like go to a higher college or something.
Correct. So one is missing out on boards. That is so dangerous. But suppose you go to boards, then is FOMO still there?
Less percent.
Less percentage.
Yeah, so the people with high
you and your friends leave you.
Your friends leave
you.
So does exam really create stress? Yes?
It's like, you, whenever you go to family gathering, you can't think about anything that's except for study or how will I do, what will I do, how will I give my exam. That only that's in your head. Nothing else
is there. So that is bothering for what reason actually? Is it because of exams or some other reasons? Really speaking, the stress that comes from exam, there is a lot of research people have done and they say that on an average an Indian school student gives 100 exams in his secondary schools. Is that true? Just
100?
More than that. How many exams in one class do you give? In our time it was very different, that's why I'm asking him. Our time it was only midterm exam, unit test, quarterly, half yearly.
Four to nine. From 9 to 5, then 10, 6, 7, depends on the school.
No, that is the annual exam you are talking about.
Yeah. Like,
I'm talking through the whole year. In 1 year, how many tests do you give?
Like CRM is every week. 20-20 mark. Depends.
Now we have
university. I haven't given that
20-20 mark.
Total number of tests. Let us say in 6th standard I gave like 30 tests in 1 year. Suppose 5 subjects I have and 6 tests per year, including unit test, quarterly, half yearly, prelims. Like that, in one standard, how many tests you give per subject?
Per subject, 3 per term.
3 per term.
Or 3 per
and how many terms you have?
2.
So 6 per subject.
Yes.
And how many subjects? 5.
Oh, yeah.
10.
7.
7.
11.
10.
10 subjects.
10 at least. 10, 10, 0, 10.
Yeah.
Then it reduces to 6. Six.
So
I have only 6.
Seven.
After 7, 8 standard, we are only 5. In 8 standard, we are only 6.
Till 8, we have 11.
It's a different situation for me because my exams will start when I go 90. And in Bonjo, I give at least 50 exams.
50?
Yeah, at least 50 papers.
So when this many exams one is giving, they say that 37% of Indian students reported high to very high levels of exam anxiety. One out of every 3 students. You go through exam anxiety, like you said, when you go to family gathering or wherever, you are not able to think anything else except exam. Or you will leave it saying, forget it. Butterflies in the stomach. But if you constantly keep having exams, then you will keep constantly going through that stress full time. So exam does create a lot of pressure in that sense. So why are we still stressed out by something that we have done more than 100 times? In a year, you must be doing 50-60 times.
Because
it's
a different test.
It's
a different subject. It's like a different part of each subject.
Because each year when you move on, even though you have done it 100 times, the level gets harder and harder each and every
year. Correct. Level
and
gets harder
and
more.
Competitive.
And annoying.
Annoying.
My friend, he gets like 69 marks in his. It's bad. He changes his marks from 2.5.
How?
He changes his marks.
How
can he change his marks, boss?
Editing.
Just by writing on the paper, what is in the records doesn't change.
No. It's simple. You use the same pen, you copy your teacher's handwriting, you change it to.
Are you, but teachers already recorded the marks and given you the paper, no?
Yes, that.
So then you can change the records.
And even more, since more found his English paper, which he forgot to change marks. And then he got caught.
But this
is
yeah. Even if you do all that cheating, how does it matter? What is the record is actually going to show the facts in you. So anyway, the point here is to think about this, that okay, the level goes up every year, no doubt, concepts are more tougher. But if something is giving, if I have done something repeatedly, should I not get a hang of it? He's saying, this is how I'm going to deal with it. My question to you now is, do we actually fear exams?
No, fear failing.
That is what we fear. We don't fear exams actually speaking.
Getting shouted by our parents.
Correct.
And the surroundings that get created is what increases the fear.
Correct.
Like your friend getting high marks and then you look like an idiot in front of the class.
Your whole class teasing you for being dumb.
So those are actually those fears, not the exam fear, not the marks fear.
The other thing is a
what peers think about me, what society thinks about me. Correct, we wouldn't be scared of exams. So is that a good thing or no?
Depends. For me it depends.
Why?
If it's my chance for English, I keep my pants.
But without fear, you can still be motivated to study. If you love that subject.
If you really chill about it, if you're not worried, then you won't study that much. Like, unless I'm like actually terrified for an exam, I won't
study. But is that knowledge going to be anyway keep going deep into me when I'm studying it because I'm worried and just trying to perform and I just forget it? So maybe fear does motivate to do something, but really speaking, when we want to achieve something great, we need to get out of the fear of that. See, one is like so many of you said, we are not actually afraid of the exam, but we are afraid of the consequences of the exam. That what all this brings with it, you know, the expectations from parents and teachers, and if I am not able to fulfill those, how they will talk to me, what they will behave with me, how they will fire me. I'm scared of that. So exam brings attention because of that.
Because when you get bad marks, your mom and dad should fire at you.
Exactly. So then I'm scared of that situation. I don't want that fire to be there on me. So all my peers, how they perform, if they exceed, then everybody will say, see, your friends, they went ahead of you, you got left behind, what are you doing? So that also peer pressure adds. I'm scared of punishments also.
Like, compare and ask, what parents are saying, 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 what parents are saying
performance of peers, expectations, comparisons, punishments, career prospects. So many people actually think that if they don't get a particular percentage and they don't get an admission in a particular institution, their future is ruined.
Not true.
Exactly. We should remember that part. What is an exam? It's just a performance of yours in that subject on that particular day. That's all. It cannot define your whole life.
According to me, exam is a known paper you have to give so that teachers can test your performance and see if you are dumb or you are smart.
It's actually just testing your repetition and memorization skills, nothing else.
No repetition, you mean your copy?
But this is going to
How do you say it is spoiled? Suppose I didn't get admission into IIT.
Yeah,
I can still be successful.
Yesterday only I heard it from mom. There was one child, I also don't know. My mom's Masi, like sister told to that one student got in Somaya College, he did engineering over there. And he didn't get an IIT. So he is getting a less pay even after he knows everything. Like
yeah,
the same
so the IIT is a certain badge they give to people, and that reputation does give them extra credit.
Correct. But what I am saying is,
it's like the smarter
if you come,
more favor than
if you come down
no,
the badge
no
of IIT,
you can go to a different school and know as much as an IIT.
With this person, so socially, yes, it may appear that yes, he got less amount and this guy got more amount because he has IIT badge. But success in life doesn't depend only on that. If that person actually begins a startup or whatever he wants to do, he starts up and he does something innovative, he will become very successful. Dr. Kalam never went to any IIT. But what a great scientist he became. You know, so many of these. So yes, it has a value at one level, no doubt. But at the other level, we should also know that to be really successful in life, there are lots of things possible. So many people, you see like that YouTuber is, somebody gave the name of that guy. So many YouTubers, if you see the guy who earns the highest as a YouTuber, for the videos that he makes, he doesn't have any technical qualifications, skill or nothing. I forget his name, it starts with J. In India, the latest YouTube sensation, the biggest one is who? Bhuvan Bam. What's his name?
Yeah, there are many actually. He's not the top maybe now.
Maybe now, yeah, he may come down now. But I'm saying what technical expertise he may not have so much, But he still made a mark for himself because he has innovative abilities. He thought through something very nice. He made something which was relatable to people. So, idea is that yes, a badge may matter, no doubt. But what is important is my inner capability. So, exam does create all these issues because a lot of people connect their self-worth with this. If I am a topper, I feel confident. If I come one level down also, I feel less about myself. How can a performance in an exam make me feel less or more about me? It's just numbers. I am such so much more than that. But unfortunately, one doesn't understand some of this at that particular stage in one's life. And so we find that so many youngsters, they go into what? Drugs, into depression, into suicidal tendencies because they didn't get particular percentage and they didn't get particular results. So they didn't get into a particular college. Life is so much more than that. So in our next session, we will actually see about what kind of pressure which is there, how do we get out of that and see the bigger picture of life. So that we don't miss out on the bigger aspect of life. While we may have work hard, succeed in the world, achieve great things, even in exams we should do well, no denial of that, but not out of this kind of stress, comparison, fear, all that must go out. Then really the potential will manifest and we will be able to succeed in whichever aspect of life. So exams are not just about exam, it's a life skill. They are representing many, many situations which put pressure on us to perform. How do I learn to face those kind of situations is what we will take up in our next session. So what is the secret of facing challenges successfully? Think about it for a week. When you come back, we can share some ideas. Then we'll go.
Just try your best.
If you try your best, even if you fail your exam, you know you try. True, that's a good one. So for today, we will stop here. Did you enjoy our sessions today?
Yes, sir. Yes, sir.
My name is Swami Swatmananda. I stay here only in June. I'm in charge of Chinma Mission, Mumbai. So we have 8 centers in Mumbai, different places. So I do classes all over Mumbai, but mainly in this area. I also done my graduation in commerce and programming in computer. And then I studied in our institute at Powai. Near Renaissance Hotel, we have our headquarters of Chinma Mission. So
yeah, Chinma Mission is even like in America.
Yeah, it's in 25 countries. It's a global organization. We have more than 108 schools, colleges. We do a lot of rural development work in about 1,000 villages. We have orphanage, hospital, old age homes, many things, many initiatives to serve the society. So I'll meet you next week. We'll conclude with a small prayer. Om Asatoma Sarkamaya Tamasoma Jyotirgamaya Mrityorma Amritam Gamaya Om Shanti 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 Hari Om Shri Guru Namaha.